Haters of Scott Summer Work hard, play harder
Ghetto Tag, can I eat you new kiss? Kawasaki, umare no b-boy Tag, sara b-boy, kada naru b-yo
The Dallas Mavericks arriving at the building earlier today. There's no lack of focus among that group. Time to start the weekend in style. We welcome you to Friday Night Basketball on 2K Sports. And in our matchup tonight, we'll see the Dallas Mavericks going up against the Denver Nuggets here in Ball Arena. I'm Brian Anderson. Alongside Clark Kellogg and Grant Hill, Allie LaForce is our reporter. We are now into November, so let's check in on the standings in the Western Conference. Taking a look at the Nuggets. They're in 10th place, but it's early on, so they have time to recover. And, of course, the Dallas Mavericks, half a game behind.
You know, for Denver, they're just not where they thought they'd be as a ball club. Now, after the success they had last season, they were counting on having even a better year.
And you know what? Even though the season hasn't been a complete disaster, they're pretty dysfunctional as a team right now.
So the opening lineup for the Mavericks. Luka and Kyrie are the talented backcourt. Hardaway Jr. is the three with Williams at the four. And it's Powell in at the pivot spot, manning the middle. And for the Nuggets. And the forward spots, Porter Jr. and Gordon. Then there's Reggie Jackson, and it's Lowry in at the center position. Well, Clark, on paper, a bit of a mismatch here. A clear favorite in this one.
And, you know, that bodes well, I think, for the underdog because there's nothing to lose. Nobody is expecting you to prevail, and it gives you a chance to play, I think, with a lot of freedom.
Here's Jennings. Launches a three. And he buries his first look.
And that's what they want to do. Get him open looks early.
And so it's Irving with it. He brings it up for the Mavs. It's a three-point game. This game coming after a loss versus the Bulls.
I really think that L has to fall on their defense, or a lack thereof. Just not enough focus at that end of the floor.
Yeah, and that's really inexcusable. I mean, there's just no way that you can justify that. When you don't put the work in on defense, you're going to end up on the losing end.
Just an uncanny ability to make shots from the corner. Porter Jr. using his skill set.
Doncic on the wing, coming off a 31-point game against Chicago. And there's a whistle. He'll head to the line to shoot two. It's going to go on Reggie Jackson. You know, when you think about Kyrie Irving's game, his ball handling is what still comes to mind first.
Yeah, you know, B.A., that and his killer instinct. Kyrie is one of the most creative players we've ever seen. A guy you can count on to come through in big moments.
And he makes a first. And finally getting to full strength last season, the Nuggets showing how great they can be, Grant.
Well, the franchise's first ever championship, B.A. And you look at all their top players just entering their primes. Plenty of runway left ahead of them.
Both free throws good from Irving. You know, Clark, when you think about the history of this Dallas franchise, one man stands out. That's Dirk.
Yeah, he's worthy of a statue for sure, B.A. He played all 21 seasons of his career with the Mavs. He was the first European MVP in league history. And then in 2011, he helped bring an NBA title to the Mavericks, beating the LeBron Wade-led Heat team. Watch out now when Doncic is dialed in from deep because he's unguardable.
First quarter and about a minute and a half in. Jennings, no good.
It's never easy from that distance, but we see him drill those and shoot around all the time.
Well, that looked to me, guys, like a heat check and was maybe a step out of his range. He does not lack for confidence, and he shouldn't. I mean, this guy's a dangerous scorer.
Now here's Jackson. 11 points for him last game against Minnesota.
And his assist numbers were remarkable as well. His play is crucial to this team's success.
Count it. Jennings has got 5 points.
Intelligent basketball. Keep feeding the hot hand.
Doncic outside. On the wing, Irving. Defended by Jackson. Powell, a screen on Jackson. And play stops. A whistle there on what looks like an illegal screen.
Well, the league has put an emphasis to crack down on illegal screens.
Yeah, you know, he might have gotten away with that a few years ago, but not anymore. No way. Now you've got to be stationary on those screens. No extra hips or elbows, or they'll call it.
Now here's Jackson. Gordon on the wing and out of bounds. Dallas will have it. And now a look back at last year's top shooting teams in the NBA. Number one, Denver.
Tremendous efficiency on offense. They were willing to put in their work to get great looks.
Here in the first, just under 2.5 minutes played so far. Outside Irving. Back to Doncic. Williams with the screen. Doncic, no good.
Very surprising that he came away empty there, especially given room to operate.
Pass to Gordon. Hardaway against Porter. Lowry outside. Over Williams. Lowry, no good. For Dallas, they've gone just 2 for 4 from the floor. Doncic against Jackson. Again, the miss by the Mavericks. For Denver, they've gone 3 of 6 from the floor. Here's Jennings. Launches it from deep. It's hauled in by Luka Doncic. And so it's Doncic with it. He brings it up for Dallas to the paint. Here's Williams. And Williams punches it home.
Luka's peripheral vision off the charts. Get wide open, and he's going to find you.
Gordon outside. Pass to Jennings. And he knocks it down. He's 3 of 5 now from the floor.
And credit his teammates for feeding him all quarter.
Dallas has gone 2 for 3 from outside the arc. Jackson against Irving. Doncic, a screen on Jackson. Doncic outside. Clock at 6. Releases. The rebound by Lowry. Lowry's got 4 rebounds now.
Boy, just not scoring with the efficiency he'd like to. Tough quarter for him.
He's been a steady presence for them. Nice to have that kind of safety net at the offensive end.
Outside Irving. Shoots over Jackson. And Irving, the bucket on the assist from Doncic. Doncic has got 3 assists now in this one. Here's Jennings. Williams defending. There's a screen. 3-pointer. Jennings, no good. The Mavericks have gone 4 of 8 and looking in control. It's Doncic with a drive. Powell passes to Williams. Kicks it out to Hardaway. Powell sets a screen. Tries again. The rebound by Lowry. Lowry's got 5 rebounds in the game. To the inside. It's rebounded by Dallas. Pass to Irving. Back to Doncic. Powell, a screen on Jackson. Powell with it. The shot is good. Doncic making the play. Doncic has got his 4th assist with that last one. Jackson, the pass to Gordon. Pass to Jennings. And you can count it. He'll go to the line with a chance at a 3-point play.
He's putting them to the test this quarter, attacking every chance he gets.
All right, guys, what do you think so far on the offensive approach for the Nuggets?
Well, we're in the era of the 3-point basket. So if you want to win games in this league, you have to connect from deep, and they have been thus far.
Cultivating a lot of assists right now, which is beautiful to see. Love the way they're working that ball around.
The NBA season just getting going. fall is coming in full force. Grant, there's nothing quite like this time of year.
It's the best time of the year, and I'm chomping at the bit. I mean, every fan is excited and, of course, optimistic. You know, fans all over are excited to see the new faces on their team, so nothing can beat some good old basketball in the fall.
Now here's Jackson. He's scoreless to the paint. And it's flushed down! A nice jam.
Then put your head down and go to work. That's what they need to do.
Yeah, these teams trading punches right now. I mean, it's table tennis. Back and forth we go.
Here's Doncic. He's got six. Irving, no good.
And he almost made them regret defending him so loosely.
Jackson, pass to Jennings. From the wing, ooh, he's found his rhythm. 7 for 10 and counting.
Pick works well there, but the defense left a lot to be desired.
Yeah, that's not the defense you need. You got to be tougher defensively.
Doncic outside. Irving against Jackson. And it's Irving missing.
Oh, gritty defense. Protecting the rim at all costs against a guy who has all sorts of ways to finish.
Pass to Lowry. Now here's Porter. Here's Jennings. Cash. Assisting on the play was Porter. Now it's a 5-point Nugget lead.
If it ain't broke, don't fix it. They should continue to ride the hot hand.
Outside Irving. And here's Doncic outside. Gordon pulls it in.
That's his shot. And one, I'm sure, he wants back.
Boy, the offense has been on point.
They have great timing and great communication. So hard to get stops against them. This has not been his best quarter.
You know, guys, it seems to me as though he's over-anxious. He seems to be pressing, trying too hard, moving too fast. Just needs to calm himself down and wait for good shots.
And their offense looking like a well-oiled machine.
Yeah, shots falling, off to a very good start offensively as a result.
And the Mavericks call time here. For the Nuggets, Naji, he's checked in for Gordon. Brown comes in for Michael Porter. And Caldwell Pope is subbed in for Jackson. Caldwell Pope against Curry. Outside, Green. On the wing, Curry. Six to shoot. Dallas needs to get off a shot. Drops in the three. Doncic has got nine.
The guard attributes on display there. Luka with one of the quicker releases you'll see in the game.
And if you're looking for a knockdown shooter from distance, look no further than Seth Curry.
Well, not many guys have hit over 40% from three for their careers. And Seth Curry is in that exclusive club. And as a huge bonus, he protects the basketball and doesn't turn it over.
And Grant, the Nuggets are in uncharted territory this year. They are the defending champs.
Yeah, B.A. I mean, they'll have a target on their back all season. They retain most of their talent and core, and with Jokic leading the way, they remain favorites to repeat.
The first one falls. One thing you can count on with this Mavericks team, they shoot threes.
All night long, if you let them. I mean, near the top of the league for attempts beyond the arc, they do it every chance they can get.
That one goes in. Two from the line that time. Grant, when teams come to play the Denver Nuggets, it's not just another regular game in a normal city.
Yeah, I mean, the altitude of the Mile High City is an adjustment for many players, B.A. Even if some guys say it doesn't affect them, don't let them fool you. It takes some getting used to. Trust me, I know. Grab that one. However, so far, they're getting a little out-hustled on the boards.
And because it's still early, I wouldn't read too much into it. There's still a lot of game left.
And Curry's got the ball here for the Mavs. They trail by seven. that one's good. And Green with the assist.
Nice body control by Seth Curry. I mean, he's so good at fending off defenders on the way up.
Lowry with a screen on Williams. Here's Jennings. 14 points for him last game against Minnesota.
And on top of everything else, he did a great job of helping control the boards at both ends.
And the Nuggets making a change here. Watson's checked in. Kleba, he's checked in for the Mavericks. Lowry outside. Caldwell Pope against Curry. Clock at 6. Out to Lowry. Lets it go from deep. And the rebound goes to the Mavericks. Now Curry. He's coming off a 13-point game against Chicago.
Boy, I thought his passing was absolutely fantastic. I mean, really picked apart the defense all game long.
Not his best night, and not the team's best night. Sometimes it just goes that way.
Caldwell Pope, the pass to Lowry. Here's Watson. He's covered by Curry. And it's Watson missing. The Mavericks trailing. There's the triple. Rebound by the Nuggets. Lowry's got rebound number 9 now. What an effort here tonight. Pass to Brown. This one for 3. It's rebounded by Kleba. And for Dallas, they're shooting just 38% so far in this one. Green, the pass to Doncic. Puts up a 3. It's hauled in by the Nuggets. Lowry's got double-digit rebounds now in the game. Caldwell Pope sinks the tray. And the Nuggets lead by 8.
Attacking immediately.
Caldwell Pope fires the moment he finds his angle.
51 seconds left to play in the first. Here's Doncic. Oh, the teardrop falls in. Doncic has got 11 points.
Can't blame the deficit on him. He's been scoring at will this period.
Pass to Naji. Jones against Lowry. Outside, Caldwell Pope. Takes the 3. The Nuggets hit again from deep.
And with his height, the defense unable to impact the shot on the closeout.
And it's the Mavericks with the ball. 9-point game. 1 second separating the shot clock and the game clock. Doncic passes to Curry. Kleba, screen on Caldwell Pope. And it's Dallas scoring again.
Seth Curry's game in the mid-range area continues to look better, taking advantage of all opportunities.
Oh, he got it up in time, but it wouldn't fall for him. Well, offense is the order of the day as the first quarter comes to a close. The Nuggets on top, up by 7. And back in a moment as we'll get underway with quarter number 2. For those of you just tuning in, second quarter action is where we are. And from what you've seen from the Nuggets, what's your take so far?
Oh, what I love was that first quarter was all about leaking out and capitalizing in transition.
Yeah, I like the way they play. They're looking to get up and down the court every time. Racehorse basketball here tonight. Strap it up. Don't look down. You'll miss something.
And for Dallas, they're shooting only 42%. We've got Christian Brown. Kentavious Caldwell-Pope out there with Zeke Nagy. And it's Tyson in at the 4. That's the group for Denver getting going in the second. Now here's Curry. Kleba with a screen. Five on the clock. From the right block. And here's Green from the arc. And it's Tyson with a rebound.
That's excellent defense right there on the perimeter.
Here's Caldwell Pope. With nobody on him, he buries that jumper. Caldwell Pope's got his second basket of the night.
Love the rise and fire approach from KCP. Gotta be impressed with this guy's confidence.
Irving finds Kleba. Curry with it. Irving for three. Counted from distance. Irving's got 7 points.
That's a textbook example of how to move the ball. Boy, you gotta love that action.
Pass to Naji from deep. Rebounded by Green. And so it's Green who brings up the ball for the Mavs. They trail by 6. And at home for the next game, it'll be Charlotte pulling in to face them. And that's a 1-game homestand for the club. It's tipped! Caldwell Pope, the pass to Jennings. They double him with Curry. Here's Tyson. Over Green. Here's Naji. After missing his first attempt, now 1 for 2.
That'll drive your coach crazy, failing to box out. Ugh.
Those are free points you're giving away. You gotta work harder on the glass.
Now here's Irving. 43 points last game out. Outside Curry. And they call an illegal screen here.
And they shot well from the field. Top half in the league in that respect. Some of it just came down to patience and discipline.
They took care of the ball, stayed in control. It was very hard to turn them over. Jordan's checked in for the Nuggets. Denver's gone 6 of 14 from the perimeter tonight. Outside, Caldwell Pope. Down low. Pass to Naji. And here's Caldwell Pope. Naji sets a screen. The three. Oh, drew the foul and almost hit the three-point bucket. But he'll head to the line for three.
Yeah, he's a guy who looks for his shot often. He's energetic and outstanding at forcing the issue. Caldwell Pope is his name.
Three shots.
And he's good on the first of three. And Grant is someone whose career spanned eras. You feel playing defense is more difficult than it was 2 decades ago?
Oh, B.A., it's much more difficult. In part because the contact allowed is much more strict. Shooters can create contact and be rewarded with free throws. And the skill level on offense has truly raised. It makes it tough for the defender to really get down and play that tough-nosed defense.
And Grant, the Mavericks this summer committing to their superstar tandem of Kyrie Irving and Luka Doncic.
Yeah, B.A., and the next step was surrounding them with the defense and floor spacing they'll need to compete. Overall, I like the moves they made, and we'll see how it all pans out come April.
And he makes all three. And when you watch this Nuggets team, Clark, their chemistry on the court is obvious.
Yeah, B.A., the pieces just fit, and fit quite nicely. Give a lot of credit to the front office, doing a good job drafting, and then finding the right veterans to complement who they already had. Give Irving some room to get it off that little floating jump shot of his, and you'll regret it for sure.
Jordan, the pass to Brown. Here's Jennings. He's covered by Curry. Pass to Caldwell Pope. And down it goes. Jam that one home.
Woo! Defensively, you can't afford to let him get to the rim that easily.
Well, that might be why their deficit is what it is right now.
You know, you look at it, the communication is lacking, as is the trust. They can ill afford those types of breakdowns. It won't work. You can't win with those kind of breakdowns.
All right, let's check in with Allie LaForce.
After the trade for Kyrie Irving, the Mavericks' offense went to another level. Coach Jason Kidd said, quote, "We're still going to preach defense, but on the offensive end, there's going to be nights where we're scoring 130 or 140. Kai gives us another weapon. Someone is going to be free. Someone is going to have the advantage." Brian?
Oh, nice stuff. Thank you, Allie. Here's Jennings. Rebounded by Green.
And he probably thought he was going to bury that one.
And just over 3.5 minutes played here in the second quarter. Shot is good by Kleba.
Boy, a big man with great touch from deep. Always a valuable commodity in today's game.
Here's Jennings. And it's Denver with another.
And just totally relentless. Only increasing the intensity level.
Yeah, I love the fact he doesn't play the score. He just keeps coming. Attack mode. He doesn't know how to step off the gas pedal.
Now here's Irving. 9 points in the game.
The defense made an impact right there. Definitely got him uncomfortable going up with it.
Caldwell Pope finds Jordan. Jones with some nice D.
Yeah, you know what, guys? He's not very effective from that spot. He's got to put some work in there.
Back to Irving. Right side Curry. Let's it fly from 18. And he got the whistle on the way up. So he'll be headed to the line for a pair. Thinking back to one of the most fun runs in the NBA, Grant, those early 2000 Mavs teams.
Oh, I played against those teams, and they were incredible offensively. Of course, you had Steve Nash running the point, Dirk and Finley on the wings, and the pace they played with, they were well ahead of their time.
One falls for him.
And you know, for Curry, getting into the league has been a battle for Seth. I mean, he's more established and playing with more confidence now.
Gordon, he's checked in for Denver. Jackson comes in for Brown. And Dallas with a change here, too. Williams has checked in for Kleba. He's perfect from the line this time.
Productive trip to the line. He doesn't like to leave points on the table.
Jackson against Curry. Pass to Jennings. And Williams over to help. Gordon on the wing. He drops it from range. Gordon's got his first bucket of the game, and he's on the board for three.
I think this is an area that Gordon has really improved. Now a legitimate threat from outside the arc.
Now here's Jones. Puts up a three. Always a nice way to start. Makes his first one.
This is just fun. These teams are trading threes back and forth.
Nothing like answering back. One team gets three, you fire three of your own. Boom.
Jackson with it. Now guarded by Curry. To the left wing. And Irving comes to help. Here's Jordan. It's rebounded by Dallas. Right side Curry. Williams.
A precision passer, Curry, also excellent at seeing his guys when they're open.
Denver in the lead. Pass to Gordon. Caldwell Pope against Green. This one for three. And another three for Denver.
Another triple for him. His fourth of the night after that monster first quarter where he hit three of them.
Jones sets a screen. Outside for Irving. Fires from deep. Rebound by Jackson. Denver has got 3 of 5 to fall from beyond the three-point line in the second. Caldwell Pope, the pass to Jackson. Pass to Jennings. To the wing on the left. Gordon outside. The Nuggets need to get one up. Jennings, no good. And Curry's got the ball here for the Dallas Mavericks. A 12-point game. Irving finds Curry. Outside Jones. Outside Green. Irving for three. Gets the three to fall. Irving's got 12.
That's his second triple this quarter. I guess he's left that dry spell behind.
Jackson, the pass to Jennings. Yes, and a nice assist from Jackson. Jackson's got 3 assists in the game.
And it's Jackson's responsibility to find his open teammates in a terrific dime there.
And Dallas calls time here. Lowry, he's checked in for Denver. Porter Jr. comes in for Caldwell Pope. And it's time to give you a look at the top 3-point shooting teams from a year ago. Fourth, Denver.
That kind of efficiency from range is generally an indicator of a dominant offense.
The Mavericks have gotten 6 of their 12 attempts to go since the end of the first. Doncic on the wing. 11 points in the game. Good work there as it goes. The Nuggets have gotten 8 of 14 shots to drop so far in the second. Here's Jennings. Williams defending. Puts the move on. Jennings' shot is good. Jennings has got 9 points now in the quarter.
And the defense has no one to blame but themselves. I mean, they just let him get right to the rim.
You know, he should be getting extra attention from the defense, not less.
Now here's Curry. He has 6. And he'll draw the foul. He'll head to the line for 2.
Well, Clark, when you talk about Doncic, he came into the league with a ton of experience under his belt.
Yeah, and I think people undervalued the experience of being a pro at the age of 16. It wasn't the NBA, but it's still professional basketball that he played in Europe. And that seasoning and that competition and that being refined in the fire allowed Doncic to step into the NBA unfazed.
That's good from Doncic.
Luka Doncic is a do-it-all player. I mean, he does everything for this team, including being a walking triple-double threat on a game-by-game basis.
Doncic hits them both.
Getting themselves to the line this quarter is a good way to get their offense rolling.
And maybe cause some foul trouble along the way as well. And we know what that can do. It pays off typically in good fashion for you.
Dallas has gone 4 of 7 from 3 during the second quarter. Outside Hardaway. Pass to Williams. Back to Hardaway. Outside Curry, 6 on the shot clock, drains the triple. Curry's got 5 points now in the quarter.
This quarter, they're doing some real damage from outside the arc, trying to stay within striking distance.
Jackson surveying the D. Inside. Outside for Porter. And he can't answer back. The 3-pointer offline. The Mavericks trailing. Doncic up top. He's got 15. Curry finds Doncic. Powell sets a screen. From behind the arc. Doncic, no good.
In the first quarter, he was killing them from outside. But he can't get it going here.
Jackson against Curry. Jackson, the pass to Jennings. And Williams over to help. For 3, Lowry. That one falls. His second make in 5 attempts.
Showing great awareness and quick decision-making. That's how you handle getting double-teamed.
Doncic outside. Doncic on the take. And it's Denver with a rebound. They come into this one following the loss to Minnesota.
And I'll tell you what a surprising result. Losing to an underdog is one thing, but getting blown out is quite another.
I know. I mean, I'm with you there. It just seemed as though they were sleepwalking their way through that entire game. It was, in my estimation, just inexcusable.
With the teardrop, and Hardaway lays it up and in. Hardaway's got 5 points.
Boy, excellent situational awareness from Hardaway Jr. that time. I mean, he seems to know exactly where to get when the break is on.
Now a timeout called by Denver. Nuggets making a change here. Caldwell Pope's checked in. And Dallas also making a switch. Irving's checked in.
seconds remaining in the first.
Lowry finds Jackson. And he lobs it up to the rim. And it's Lowry with the jam.
Woo! I just love that alley-oop slam, B.A.
Defense disorganized. Defense pays.
Well, I tell you what, guys, this is really getting close to being real ugly.
Now here's Doncic. They've led by as many as 14. Shot clock at 6. Outside, Williams. Outside for Irving. Williams with the screen from the arc. Irving, no good. And so Jackson Jr. will bring it up for the Nuggets. They've got a 9-point lead. Pass to Gordon. And Irving comes to help. Irving against Gordon. The three is up. Doncic grabs the miss. Doncic has got 6 rebounds here tonight. Throws it up high. And Powell with the stuff.
Got to give it up for Powell now. I mean, he excels at rising off the ground to punch home these alley-oops.
Pass to Lowry. Yes, and a nice assist from Jackson. Jackson's got 5 assists tonight.
You know, he started slow, but now in the second quarter, he's finding his groove.
Outside, Williams. Williams knocks down the 3.
Capable of running the offense, Doncic, fantastic at getting his teammates involved.
Now here's Porter, defended by Hardaway. Porter's shot is off. Well, the Mavericks shooting it very well, 52% during the second. And the shot's good. Now just a 4-point Nugget lead.
They're punishing those late defensive rotations, getting good looks inside throughout the half.
And here's Porter outside. Nails it from 3. Porter's got 6.
How about that smooth shot from the arc for Porter? He's got such a confident release and deep range, too.
And so it's the Denver Nuggets closing out the quarter with a 7-point lead. Their key to consistency has been their dominance in the paint. They've been the more physical team. Well, now a minute to check in with Allie LaForce. She's courtside. Hey, Allie.
Thanks very much. I'm here with Mike Malone and Coach. Evaluate this team's execution offensively for me.
Well, I think we're at our best when we can get out and run, but also play downhill. It's a simple game for us. When we defend, that gets us out to run. Now we can play downhill, attack, and share the ball. That's when we're at our best.
Keep it simple. Thanks, Coach.
Thanks very much, Allie. And folks, we'll be right back to start the second half of this game.
Welcome, everyone, as we dig into the details, things working out so far for the Denver Nuggets.
Their offense reminds us of our halftime show. Efficient, entertaining, and attractive.
Yeah.
I sort of see what you're saying there, big fella. That does sound like us. Now, taking a closer look at the first half, how about the performance from these two guys?
These two are showing how good they can be. It's not easy to carry a team, but they're doing it.
Now the trick is, can both guys carry their teams for a full game? Because for what I've seen so far, they might have to.
And that'll do it for us. Thanks for stopping by. We'll head back down to Brian Anderson and crew for the start of the third quarter.
We hope you've enjoyed the broadcast thus far. We're halfway through the game. And on the floor for Jason Kidd as we get into the second half. Hardaway Jr. is the 3 with Williams at the 4. Luka and Kyrie are the talented backcourt. And it's Powell in at the 5 down low. Now here's Doncic. Lets it go from deep. They grab their own miss. Oh, and there's the whistle on the shot. So 2 free throws for him coming up.
And You know, when Powell is this deep, the defense knows they're in trouble. Sometimes they have no choice but to foul him.
And he's settled in. Powell has used his athleticism to his advantage down low, Clark.
Yeah, but he's found different ways to be successful and effective, B.A., which is what you like to see. He'll use his size to his advantage and play shoot bully two. Ball sometimes, but he also can finesse his way around you.
And the first one at the line is good.
One of the things I really like about Dwight Powell is that he doesn't play outside of himself. He plays to his strengths.
That one misses. Denver in the lead. There's Jackson with the three. And it's Irving with a rebound.
Hey, sometimes you miss even under the best of circumstances.
Doncic finds Hardaway.
Denver foul. Jennings. That's his third personal foul. Second team foul.
Outside, Williams. Pass to Powell. On the wing, Irving. Just five to shoot. The teardrop. There's the block. Jackson outside. Porter looks it over. Lowry with a screen on Hardaway. Porter against Hardaway. And here's Lowry from the arc. And the rebound goes to the Mavericks. Outside Hardaway. Pass to Doncic. Outside Irving. Deflected!
Starting slow in this half. 0-for-3 so far.
Porter, the pass to Jennings. And again, Denver no good. And so it's Doncic with it. He brings it up for the Mavs. They haven't given up any points here in the second half. Williams from long range. That one falls. Great setup by Doncic. Doncic has got assist number 8 now on the night. The Nuggets have gone 0-for-3 to start the second half. Pass to Gordon. Outside Porter. Here's Jennings. Takes the three. Powell pulls it in. Powell's got rebound number 8 now. Doncic passes to Powell. And here is Irving. Powell, a screen on Gordon. Back to Powell. And he floats it in for the easy two. Credit the sweet setup on that one.
Yeah, and I think Powell is terrific in the pick and roll. Knows how to dive after he sets the screen.
Gordon outside. Here's Jennings. Banked it in off the glass. Jennings has got 35 in the game.
Well, they get one to drop. A little relief after four straight misses to start the half.
Doncic finds Irving. Doncic left side. Porter pulls it in. Porter's got 6 rebounds in the game. The shot. That's good from Jackson on the assist by Porter. Porter's got 4 assists now tonight.
Boy, good vision that time from Michael Porter Jr. Saw the wide open teammate and then got the pass to him right on time.
And he's headed to the line for 2. He gets the whistle there.
At the line for the Mavericks, Luka Doncic taking 2 shots.
Shooting 2.
That's good from Doncic. Caldwell Pope's checked in for the Nuggets.
Doncic hits them both.
Just under 3.5 minutes played here in the third quarter. Jackson outside. Pass to Lowry. That basket is good. Off the assist from Jackson. Lowry's got 12 points in the game.
Yeah, sees the floor well. I mean, Jackson, a fantastic facilitator.
Outside Irving. Back to Doncic. In the paint, Luka!
Kyrie looking to get others involved. Nice awareness there.
Denver has got nothing to fall here in the third. 0 for 4. Jackson, the pass to Lowry. Pass to Porter. Clock at 6. Gordon down low. Williams defending. Porter's shot is off.
Yeah, and the defense has really got to tighten up on him. I mean, he's just too dangerous from the three-point line.
Doncic right side. And the Mavericks getting another bucket right there. For Denver, they've gotten just 3 of 8 shots to go in the third quarter. Pass to Lowry. No good on the shot. Oh, great D that time from Powell. And here's Doncic outside. Another miss by Doncic.
No luck for him this half after being outstanding from outside the arc in the first half.
Porter finds Jackson. Now Caldwell Pope. Pass to Gordon. Lowry with it. Williams defending. Here's Caldwell Pope. The Nuggets with another miss. Dallas is gone. Only 1 of 3 from deep here in the third. Jackson against Doncic. Back to Irving. Doncic on the wing. Given 23. 6 to shoot. For the lead. And Kyrie Irving, good for 3. Irving's got 15.
Doesn't matter if he's well guarded or not. Kyrie knocking it down from deep.
Jackson, pass to Porter. To end the drought, and he lays it in. Give him 8 points now.
Keeping pace here. That's an excellent move inside.
Dallas calls timeout.
Yeah, coach no doubt wants to use this timeout to review the matchups and maybe make some adjustments as well.
Yeah, and I agree. I think there's going to be a new wrinkle in their game plan when they come out of this timeout.
Checked in for Porter Jr. With a break here, let's see which teams racked up the assists during last year's campaign. Denver in second.
Well, I thought this team last season was a team that had some beautiful dimes. I mean, they would spread the floor with their ball movement and spacing and player movement. It was a beautiful thing to watch. Nice passes leading to baskets.
Thank you.
Williams on the wing. Pass to Hardaway. 6 on the shot clock. That shot off the mark.
Well, I like the defense there. Right up in his grill, didn't give him a chance.
You know, at this stage of Reggie Jackson's career, it's clear teams value his experience.
Yeah, he's someone this team loves having in their locker room. A strong veteran presence who serves as a mentor to his younger teammates.
Caldwell Pope with it. Now Doncic defending. On target from range. And now a 3-point Denver lead.
His first three of the half. That gives him 9 total points from beyond the arc so far.
Williams, a screen on Jackson. From deep, here's Doncic. And Gordon has got the ball here for the Denver Nuggets. They've led by as many as 14. Gordon on the wing. Oh, my goodness!
Disrespectful.
And he makes no mistake. Slam dunk.
Yeah, we saw this on display in the slam dunk contest. Gordon has some major bunnies, a creative slam dunk artist.
And it's the Mavericks with the ball, trailing by 5. Doncic against Jackson. Can they get it? Gets the bucket and the foul! It's going to go on Reggie Jackson.
Boy, this is why me and so many others are high on Doncic. I mean, he's got the ability to fight through challenges that defenses present.
And a chance to catch up on some numbers here. The scoring breakdown for the Nuggets.
Well, you know, for me, the passing has been fantastic all night. Everybody loves watching this style of basketball where the ball moves and players move. Coaches, fans, and even us broadcasters can appreciate that kind of action.
And we also got to talk about the number of points they've scored in transition. Just jumping all over the opposition in this regard.
And let's send it over to Allie LaForce.
Josh Green is becoming a key 3-and-D wing in Dallas. Mavs legend Dirk Nowitzki said, quote, he's a great defender already. He's athletic, he plays super, super hard, and now he added the 3-pointer to his game. Obviously, that's one thing he needed to get better at. He puts in a lot of work. Brian?
Well, you can see it. It has absolutely paid off. Thanks, Allie. Brown passes to Caldwell Pope. Lowry left side. Clock at 6. Shoots a fadeaway. And another basket for Denver.
Yeah, first and foremost, he's a pass-first team player, is Caldwell Pope. Love seeing that.
Outside Hardaway. Outside Jones. Pass to Powell. Lowry brings the double team. From deep, here's Doncic. Caldwell Pope pulls it in.
One reason this game is so tight is because both teams are hitting the boards with reckless abandon.
The battle to a standstill on the boards has really been something to watch. And the game's not over yet. We'll see if one of these teams maintains more energy than the other going down the stretch.
Now here's Doncic. 26 points for him. Powell, a screen on Jackson. Doncic passes to Powell. Another shot. No good there. And Lowry with the defensive effort. The Nuggets have gotten 7 of 15 shots to hit in the second half. Doncic against Jackson. And there's a pick. The 3 is up. The Mavericks pull it in. Doncic with it. Checked by Gordon. Doncic passes to Curry. Doncic deciding where to go with it. Pass to Powell. From outside the arc. And there's Doncic. That's good. On the assist from Powell. Doncic has got 12 points in just the second half. Up top, Gordon. Takes a step back. Caldwell Pope against Curry. Lowry with a screen on Curry. And Caldwell Pope gets it to go. Caldwell Pope's got 12 points.
Hey, the form, the release, everything in sync and lined up. Fun watching Caldwell Pope shoot the ball like this.
Here's Doncic. Good work defensively by Gordon.
Most nights this shot would have been his, but the defender gave him just enough trouble.
Pass to Brown. Softly drops in the floater. And it's a 5-point Denver lead.
There's a touch of artistry to the floater. Takes feel as much as skill.
Hardaway with a screen on Gordon. Jones finds Powell. Now here's Doncic. Here he goes. And Doncic with the jam.
The speed, savvy, and strength combination of Doncic, really difficult to defend.
Jackson outside. Pass to Gordon. Outside, Caldwell Pope. Now Lowry. To the middle. Here's Gordon. And Gordon with the big finish.
And this is Gordon's sweet spot. An awesome dunker who loves getting in tight and wrecking the rim.
Jones with a screen on Caldwell Pope. Oh, there's the alley! And that one is hammered home!
A bit undersized, his hops make him a legit small ball four.
Pass to Gordon. Outside, Caldwell Pope. Now here's Lowry. Shoots over Powell, and it's Denver with another.
Nice job that time by Caldwell Pope, getting it to the right man. Superb at sharing the rock with his teammates.
Right side, Hardaway. Doncic outside. And the layup falls. Doncic has got 16 points here in the second half.
It always seems like Doncic is playing with something to prove. Well, I'll tell you what, he's proving plenty tonight.
It's stolen by Doncic. We're at the end of the third quarter, and we've still got a close one. Nuggets ahead, they lead by three. And we're coming right back. Be sure to stay with us as we get set for quarter number four. And let's hear what Coach had to say during the break.
We have to make a stand defensively, fellas, okay? We're not going to be able to outscore them the whole night. We've got to get defense into the game.
A defense-first coach, Michael Malone, pleading for more effort on this end.
Yeah, it just hasn't been there, and Coach doesn't sound happy about it.
Well, this has been a great contest so far. I imagine the fourth quarter could have more action in store for us. Zeke Nagy out there with DeAndre Jordan. Then there's Kentavious Caldwell-Pope. Then there's Christian Brown. And it's prime time in at point guard. That's the group in the game for the Nuggets. Clock is at three. Fires for three. And he scores it. Now 5 of 9 from the field.
One this half, two for the game. Stay active from beyond the arc.
Outside Irving. Back to Doncic. Beyond the arc. Basket is good. Nice setup from Irving. Irving's got his fourth assist in this one.
Boy, Doncic showing you his competitiveness right there with the back at you three. The revenge triple.
Here's Jennings. Outside, Caldwell Pope.